Disperses its pollen in a manner guaranteed to give the best results. Poppies, for example, disperse their pollen in July and August between 5:30 and 10 in the morning. That is the time when bees and other insects emerge to look for food. At this point, the flower has to include in its calculation not just its own characteristics, but also those of other living things, down to the finest detail. The plant must have accurate knowledge of the time when the creatures which will fertilize it emerge, the length of the journey they will undertake, and the times they feed. In such a situation, the following question comes to mind. Where in the plant is the clock that possesses all this information, does all the necessary calculations, analyzes the features of other creatures, and works in a way reminiscent of a computer center? This clearly indicates a superior intelligence and power which establishes and controls the timing of all plants' different activities. The biological clock in plants is just one of the countless miracles of creation. It is He who sends down water from the sky. From it you drink, and from it come the shrubs among which you graze your herds. And by it He makes crops grow for you, and olives and dates and grapes and fruit of every kind. There is certainly a sign in that for people who reflect. Sharks' respiratory systems and the magnetic receptors that enable them to find their way and ability to swim very rapidly are all miracles of creation. As with all living things, God has created sharks flawlessly. White sharks, that rely heavily on vision to catch their prey, experience no difficulty when swimming off warm coral reef waters. They can easily see their prey. In cold ocean waters, however, it might be expected that their vision would be impaired by the cold, because chemical reactions slow down under the influence of the cold water. Therefore, the animal's eyes should not be able to track a fast-moving prey. Yet white sharks never encounter such difficulties because their eyes are not cold-blooded like their bodies. In this species of shark, the heat from their body's muscles is directed straight to the eyes. Thus, they can catch the fastest swimming fish and even seals. Yet how do other shark species, whose vision is too weak in cold waters to track their prey, manage to find food? The answer to this question introduces us to the perfect creation in sharks. All living things give off electricity in addition to heat. Those creatures that live on land find it hard to perceive these currents because the air serves as an insulator. But things are different in water. Water is a natural conductor of electricity. Therefore, a living thing capable of perceiving that electricity possesses a very effective sense. Sharks have this advantage to such an extent that they can perceive all the vibrations, changes in temperature and salinity levels in water, and especially the minute changes in electrical fields produced by moving creatures. A shark's body contains a large number of gel-filled vesicles. These vesicles are particularly concentrated at the head, from where they extend right through the animal's body. Known as the ampullae of Lorenzini, these magnificent electroreceptors are used by both sharks and rays to find their prey. These organs have a direct opening to the surface through pores in the animal's head and snout, and as electroreceptors, they are exceedingly sensitive. In this way, sharks perceive currents as weak as half a billionth of a volt. This is an extraordinary ability. Think of the flashlight batteries in your home. If you plant electrodes 2,000 miles apart on the ocean floor and power them with a 1.5 volt battery, sharks in between can detect the electric field produced. What we have seen so far shows that sharks have extraordinarily complex physical systems. There is evidence, like these features found in sharks, that shows us the sublime knowledge of our Almighty Lord everywhere in the universe. This evidence is a means whereby we can properly appreciate His matchless knowledge, reflect on it, and give thanks to Him. God reveals this in the Quran. Among His signs is the creation of the heavens and earth, and all the creatures He has spread about in them. The first animals one thinks of whenever the word hibernation is mentioned is without doubt bears. Scientists have recently been researching how it is that bears can remain healthy over the long months of hibernation and are looking for ways to make use of bears' physiological characteristics in the field of medicine. For example, the objective behind one piece of research being carried out at the Michigan Technological University is to find a cure for osteoporosis by studying the bone metabolism of bears. Our bones are constantly being renewed throughout our lives, yet if bone breakdown increases for reasons such as old age or immobility, and if renewal declines, then the bone tissue weakens. This is something that applies to human beings. Yet, although the American black bear remains almost totally immobile during the months it spends in hibernation, it suffers no loss in bone density. It is thought that if a human being were to remain in bed for a similar length of time, his bones would grow very brittle and break easily. An article on the subject by the research team led by Seth Donahue of Michigan Technological University in Houghton was published in the Journal of Experimental Biology in 2003. It describes how there is an increase in bone breakdown as the bear hibernates, but bone production remains constant. Immobile human beings suffer damage because breakdown increases, while bone production declines rather than remaining constant. As the animal wakens from hibernation and begins to move again, production reaches its highest level, and the bones are thus able to return rapidly to their former state. Human beings